thousands of aspiring lawyers await the release of the 2022 bar examination results. Let's check on the situation now at the grounds of the Philippine Supreme Court in Manila from our very own Adrian Ayalin. Adrian.
Hi, Carmina. Examinees and their relatives are patiently waiting for the results of the 2022 bar examinations here at the Supreme Court compound. As you can see behind me, there are examinees and relatives of examinees waiting here at the courtyard or the quadrangle of the Supreme Court. There was an LED screen set up since this morning where we are expecting that the list of successful examinees to be posted. Some of the examinees and relatives who were waiting here as early as 8 o'clock, 9 o'clock. Some of them went outside to have lunch, but some are still patiently waiting here despite the humidity and the extreme summer heat that we are experiencing right now. Although there is word going around right now that the results will be posted at 1 o'clock this afternoon. But again, some of the examinees and their relatives are patiently waiting here. Although, of course, the other examinees are waiting outside because the list of successful examinees will also be posted on the website of the Supreme Court as well as the YouTube account of the Supreme Court. So majority of the examinees will be updated through the website and YouTube accounts of the Supreme Court. There are more than 9,000 who finished the bar exams, and right now we were informed that there was an en banc session of the Supreme Court held since this morning at around 10 o'clock. After that, we are expecting that a press conference will be held to be led by the Bar Exams Committee Chair for 2022 Bar Exams, Associate Justice Alfredo Benjamin Kagiwa. And after that press conference, we will be expecting for the list of the successful examinees at the LED wall behind me. Carmina?
All right, Adrian, there are about 9,200, right, bar examinees who took the exams last year. And the tension, I guess, is building up because when you look at other websites as well, news platforms, live streaming, there are watchers there. There are eyes just really waiting for the results to come out. And you're saying that's going to happen at around 1 this afternoon. Was there any expectations, though, that this would have been out earlier today, or was 1 o'clock really the time for the results to come out?
Well, the examinees and the relatives of examinees who are waiting here outside the Supreme Court are, of course, hoping that it will be released soon. And also, we've spoken with some of the examinees whom we personally know, and they are also expecting the results to be out soon. They are in their homes, outside the premises of the Supreme Court. All of them are waiting for the exam results. And again, they are hoping that the exam results will be released. There was word that the results will be out before 12. But then again, it's past 12 now, and we are still waiting here at the Supreme Court. Carmina?
All right. And we wait along all the examinees that continue to wait for the results. Whatever the results may be, Adrian, I think you and I are one in saying job well done. It was a tough one. It's always tough, but you know, good luck to all of those who are just waiting for the results. Our very own Adrian Ayalin there, joining us live from the Supreme Court. Thanks, Adrian. An update now on the killing of Negros Oriental Governor Roel Degamo. The legal counsel of suspended lawmaker Arnulfo Teves Jr. sees no need for his client to personally attend the Senate probe into Degamo's murder. Attorney Ferdinand Topacio insists Teves has the right to attend the investigation virtually since it will be held only in aid of legislation. Teves is being considered the main mastermind in the killing of Degamo.
Ito po ay Senate hearing lang naman. Hindi naman po ito pag-iliti sa hukuman o sa piskalya. This is an inquiry in aid of legislation. So dapat po, both sides should be represented in whatever manner. Kasi hindi naman po in effect ang technical rules of evidence or procedure sa isang Senate.
Joining physically.
The widow of Degamo still finds it unfair that Teves will not be physically present in the Senate probe. Pamplona Mayor Janice Degamo says it clearly shows Teves is a coward.
kami nga, gagastos po kami ng aming oras, panahon, effort, pera, para nandoon kami. I think someone has to tell the good senator po to really think of it and think hard. Virtually, he can just blah blah anything he wants to say. Alam niyang hindi siya ma-reach, alam niyang hindi siya maaabot, hindi siya pwedeng kusasan kung may sabihin siya, hindi siya mako-contempt kung may sasabihin siya na mga mali doon sa invitation.